Ahoy, devs! Let's talk onboarding. Word has it you've just landed a new project with a new client, and though that's very exciting, you want to set the project and yourself up for success. In order to properly onboard your client, you need to understand their needs. And to do that, you need to ask some good questions. So let's hop aboard and discover how to onboard web clients successfully. The easiest way to set up a project for success is to ask the right questions, which will open up communication and help build a strong foundation between the client and yourself. Creating a client questionnaire will help you understand their needs, expectations, problems, products, budget, timeline, and many other important considerations. So, what should you include in this questionnaire? Let's cover the easy stuff first. You want to get all the basic information about your client. This includes obvious things like the name of the business, email and phone numbers, but also the mailing address. You will also want to know what specific services the company provides, as this will inform what design elements and keywords to focus on. Two of the most important questions to ask are, what sets your client apart from their competition, and who is their target client? The more information here, the better. This gives you the opportunity to design a site that plays on their strengths, shows their competitive advantages over their competition, and connects with their target demographic. Now, it's important you discover why your client is in the market for a new website. Be sure to ask about their current site, what they like about it, and why they desire to have a new website. This will allow you to see if their current site aligns with their stated goals and desired audience, and how you can improve upon the old site and deliver what the client wants. You'll also want to discover what key words they want or need to rank for, as there could be opportunity for improvement. It's hard to consider any other features when you have an amazing host like myself, but you should be specific when asking your client what features they want for their new website, especially since there are so many to choose from. And as they consider what features to have, encourage them to not forget about their goals and audience. I find it helpful when clients share other sites they like and specifically what they like about them. I meant websites, not places you love. Sorry, I'll be clearer next time. Knowing websites your client likes can speed up the design process and give clarity on designs that may be hard to describe. Your client is going to need a bunch of new content to fill out their site, and it's imperative that you ask who will provide that content to you. For one, this could open up another revenue stream for you via content as a service, but also will give you the key contact person when it's time for the content, making your life a little bit easier. Most likely your client will have some established branding, and you'll want to figure out if they do right away, as you'll want the website to align with it. Does your client want a new domain name and hosting? Do they want to move the old site to a new location? These questions may be a bit over their head and need some more explaining from you. However, they are important conversations, as these are things you need to accommodate for in your time and costs. Deadlines, deadlines, deadlines! They can be dreaded, but having conversations about the deadline up front will give you the opportunity to set the right expectations. Because maybe what they want is not realistic for their timeline. You'll also need to include the budget question. How else are you going to know if you can deliver them the most amazing website they've ever had if you don't know what their budget is? Finally, be sure to ask about website maintenance and content marketing, as these are not a part of your website build and are opportunities for recurring revenue. They may not have even been thinking about it, and it's an opportunity to educate. Otherwise, how are they going to get people to find their website, and what happens when something breaks? You know, we got this cool thing called The Hub by GoDaddy Pro. It can manage all your clients' websites from a single platform. You should seriously check it out. But more importantly, you should be liking and subscribing to these videos because we have the best web developer content. Hit the notification bell and don't miss the next episode. For every web design project, it's important for both your client and yourself to understand what needs to be done and the timeliness and budget it needs to be done within. When you onboard a new client successfully, you will ensure there are no misunderstandings and set the project up for success.